What makes us unique is the target that we picked to work with. If we get it to a stage that we can inject the first patients with our compound, to me, that will be success.
Cancer is still leading cause of death in many countries around the world. And my guest is CEO of ApoT, a biopharmaceutical company focusing on the development of new anti-cancer treatments. Marta Kianka, welcome, Marta.
Hello.
What are the challenges in general, if we're talking about today's cancer therapy?
Well, if we talk about today's cancer therapy, there are still challenges in respect to safety of the therapy, but also efficacy.
What do you mean with safety?
Safety, you would like to have a therapy which is not causing side effects. Mm. You would like patients to benefit from the therapy and not get worse from the therapy. Yeah. And both safety and efficacy very closely relate to the target that is picked and bound by the drugs that we inject into patients.
But me as a non-professional would say the target is clear, that's the cancer, right? Or not? But it's not that simple, probably.
It's not that simple.
Explain.
It's not that simple. No. So cancer, what we mean by cancer, is it's actually a very complex phenomenon. Yeah. It's uncontrolled outgrowth of cells, to put it very simple, but as you can imagine, there's more to it.
Yeah.
What I mean with target, and we talk about targeted therapy when thinking of ApoT, is how do we make our medicine recognize a healthy cell from unhealthy cell, from a cancer cell? Mm. And this has to do with the certain molecules that are present in one and the other. And these molecules are the targets. Those are the ones that are recognized by the therapeutic that we inject to the patient.
And that's a big advantage on like chemo or radiotherapy, right? Because what kind of therapies are there, if you put it in perspective?
If you put things to perspective, well, there's surgery. You can just cut out the tumor, but it's not always operative. Sometimes tumors are located in such a way that surgery is not an option, or the tumor is too big.
Yeah.
Then surgery can also not be done. You also have chemotherapy and radiotherapy, and both of them, as much as they are efficient and potent in eradicating tumors, they are not per se directed to the tumor. So healthy cells are also affected by these therapeutics, and then you get side effects.
Yeah, which we all know from chemotherapy. Yeah.
Exactly. And ideally, you would like to have a therapy that is safe and efficacious. And due to this, there's so much interest now with targeted therapies.
Yeah.
Targeted by means of using, for example, antibodies. So you have molecules which are trained to recognize cancer cells.
Only cancer cells.
Only cancer cells. They will exclusively bind cancer cells and not healthy cells. And they do it because they recognize certain things on the surface of a cancer cell.
Mm.
But if you look at the...
Like?
Well, these are different types of proteins.
Yeah.
So... if you have a look how many antibodies are approved for use in cancer, it's actually not such an impressive number because since the moment we had the first approval till now, there's between 20 and 30, maybe above 30 antibodies available. Mm. And the ones that are currently available, they bind to markers, so let's call them tumor markers, which are indeed present in high amount on a cancer cell, but still at a lower level present in healthy cells.
Mm-hmm.
And this leads to side effects, because then your targeted therapy, well, binds to the tumor cell, does its job, but can still, in some cases, cause some side effects. Mm. And at ApoT, we want to do better.
And how do you do that?
By picking the right target.
Okay, but explain what is the specific solution that makes ApoT unique?
Yeah, so there are lots of companies making antibodies, right? Yeah. ApoT is one of them, so I can completely understand your question here. What makes us unique is the target that we picked to work with.
Uh-huh.
And it's a very interesting molecule to work on, like from a scientific perspective.
You are a scientific professional.
I do have scientific background. That's why it gets me so
excited talking
excited.
About this kind
yes.
of subject. Yeah, that's why you're here. Yeah.
So we picked to work with MAGE. MAGE is actually a family of markers which are expressed, so present, in cancer cells, testis, and placenta.
Mm-hmm.
And these are intracellular proteins. Intracellular meaning that they are retained within the cell.
Not on the surface.
They are not on the surface, not yet. Not yet. But like any other protein in human body, these need to be presented on the surface of the cell because our immune system needs to distinguish self from non-self. And one of the mechanisms behind it is to present what the cell has inside on the outside, and then the T cells. Well, if it's self, they don't do anything. Mm. If it's like from a viral infection or from a tumor, then they get activated. Uh-huh. So MAGE, intracellular protein, is chopped into pieces, short peptides, yeah. So fragments of protein, loaded onto another molecule. They form complex. And then this complex from inside the cell travels to the surface and is presented, well, to the outside. And this is the moment when our APOT therapeutic can work. Because we develop antibodies, or let's say antibody-based therapeutics, that can specifically recognize peptides derived from MAGE when presented on the cell surface.
So the moment is perfect. And are there no side effects then?
No, because, like I said, MAGE is expressed in cancer cells, testis and placenta, but testis and placenta do not have this other part that makes the complex. They do not have MHC. So we have the peptide and the MHC. Mm. Together, that's our target. That means that the only place where there is target for our compound is actually the cancer cell. Only those have MHC and MAGE-derived peptides. Mm. But there's more to it, why we chose to work with MAGE. So this exclusive expression in tumors, that's one, and that contributes to the safety.
Yeah.
There's a problem with the fact that tumors acquire resistance to the treatment over time. We see it more and more often.
Yeah.
And then you cannot come back with the same therapeutic because the target is not there or the tumor is not responding. Yeah. So what do you do then? We do not think this will be a problem with MAGE as such, because MAGE has been shown to enhance oncogenic potential of the cells. So it actually makes a cell more aggressive. So it's to the benefit of a cancer cell to keep expressing MAGE. So the target is still there.
Yeah.
And on a very technical level, I told you MAGE is a family of proteins. Yeah. There are multiple members, but they are very similar to each other. So when they undergo this degradation inside the cell before they are chopped into these pieces, if you look at the sequences, it is possible to derive the same piece that is then presented in complex on the surface from different MAGE members. And that means that you can really help a lot of patients because there is variability in expression.
Yeah,
and you can account for it. And you can continue the therapy even if resistance would occur to the patient in the first instance. So one of the family members would get downregulated. The target can still be possible.
You are talking about this rather open in this conversation. Can other companies use it?
So APOT has a very broad IP portfolio.
Yeah.
And we're constantly adding to it.
Yeah.
And well, the reason why I can talk about it now so openly is because this is already covered in our.
You're a small team, right?
We are a small team, but the way I think of it, we're small but very effective.
Yeah, that's in most cases of small companies the case. And how many years are you? If you're looking at the process of like the initial idea of this, and then of course at the end it must go onto the market. Where are you now?
So we are in preclinical stage.
Yeah.
Meaning that we are running our animal in vivo proof of concepts. Mm-hmm. So we're checking whether the compounds that we have in our pipeline are working in vivo models, in animal models.
Yeah.
When that is the case, then we will move to the GMP production of the lead candidate.
Yeah.
That would then undergo clinical evaluation in clinical trials.
And if we're looking at planning time schedules?
Yes, I would expect APOT to be in clinical trials in the course of the next 2 to 3 years.
Okay, is that, and then we have a total development process from scratch
Then we have a proof of concept in human. So then we can say that yes, the compound is safe.
Yeah.
Maybe we can also see some efficacy. Well, we will design the trial in a way that we can acquire as much information as possible.
Yeah.
So ideally, we would like to see efficacy already at that stage.
Yeah.
Then it still needs to go through phase 2 and 3.
And that will take?
I think you need to count roughly 3 years for each. So making a drug, a therapeutic, takes between 8 to 15 years.
Incredible. And how do you know? Because it's a competitive market, right? What is the risk that at the end it's a good, it works and everything goes to the market, that there are other companies that have a similar or better treatment for cancer than APOT?
Well, cancer is a very complex phenomenon. Yeah. It's actually a subset of diseases. I think this is the most correct way of looking at it.
Yeah.
I doubt that it's possible to have one universal drug
that solves
the problem. And lately we see so much of those combination therapies that you do chemotherapy plus targeted therapy, or a radiotherapy supplemented by targeted therapy, or with immune checkpoint inhibitors. So there's so many people suffering from cancer, and we have a target which is prevalent in many cases. Actually, if you take a look at the 10 most deadly cancers, MAGE has been shown, and it's a fact, to be expressed in all of them. So of course, we, as a small company, we need to focus on a certain indication, but we do have the possibility to expand to other indications, which also is unique. Because if you dive into those 30 antibodies currently approved for use in clinics, it's only a couple of them that can be used across indications. And that again has to do with the presence of the target.
So the market, so to speak, is really big.
I'm not worried about that aspect.
How you're small, 8 to 15 years, you're already busy a couple of years. That costs a lot of money.
It does.
How does a business case work?
So APOT is a completely a privately backed up company.
Yeah.
We have our shareholders who's been with the company since the very early days, the beginning, and they are still with us, and they have expressed their support for the activities that we're running at this moment. But like you say, this is a very competitive, a very busy environment, which if you want to make a real change and bring the innovation to the market, that requires substantial financing. So yes, we're looking at expanding the current.
And how do you do that? With funding?
With funding.
And what kind of investors do you approach then?
Well, we approach, we take multiple approaches.
Yeah.
That has to do, again, with the fact that we're small. Besides getting money from investors, and whether those are angels or VCs, you can also apply for non-dilutive funding, so grants.
Yeah.
And this is something that APOT
from
is
KVF
also...
KVF or other...
For example, from KVF, which we recently got, and that is in collaboration with Utrecht University. Previously, we also got a grant from ZonMV, and that was for work together with Utrecht Medical Center, with a group of Professor Klumperman. We also get support from the Dutch government. APOT received an innovation credit. So we do explore all the possibilities which are out there. Yes.
Yeah, because it's not about the money, but you do need it.
You do need the money to do proper science, and we want to do our job properly.
Yeah.
We want to develop a drug which is safe and efficacious, from which patients can benefit.
Yeah, and if you're looking at an entrepreneurial way, you could say, let's join forces with other small companies or organizations and work together. Is that?
We do collaborate with others. Like you say, it's a joint effort.
Yeah.
We also start up new collaborations as we speak now. So
okay.
Perhaps we can have another meeting in some time, and then I can tell you more about that.
Yeah, working on it. Hey, and your personal role, because you are in the net, it's in Os, right, where you are situated?
Yes, APOT is based in Os.
In Os. But you're not Dutch?
I'm not Dutch.
So tell me a little bit about how did you get in contact with APOT, and how did that come?
It's actually pretty simple.
Yeah.
I came to Netherlands to do my PhD.
Yeah.
I never intended to stay in...
Why did you come to the Netherlands to do it?
Well, you have top universities here.
Okay.
And very good climate for collaboration between academia and industry.
Uh-huh.
And since I never wanted to stay for long in academic setting, but really wanted to move on to industry, this made a lot of sense to me. So I did my PhD at Utrecht University, and then started working for a small startup, but a CRO, which was good at the time, but I was missing one key element there. that CRO was making nanobodies for clients, which is a lot of, it's a very satisfactory process. You make a molecule, you give it to the client, they're happy with it, they work on it. But you never get to see what happens with it after after a while. So I was looking for a job where I could work on innovative projects and see how they develop in time and how we get our next milestones and really bring the innovation closer to patients. And this is what APOT offers.
What are your ambitions for the next, say, how far do you look ahead? 2 years, 3 years?
2 to 3 years.
2 to 3 years. Tell me, what's on your ambitious schedule?
Well, making APOT a success, that's the biggest ambition. And by success, I mean, if we get it to a stage that we can inject the first patients with our compound, to me, that will be success. That means that our drug leaves our laboratory in us and actually gets to the bedside in a hospital. And then
how it works.
Be.
And what year will that happen?
Could you repeat?
In what year will that happen?
We expect to start the clinical trials 3 years from now.
Okay. That's the trial, that's your first step?
That's the first step, yes.
And then it will take another year, still a couple of years until it will be commercially available. So 2 to 3 years.
To first have it in patients, yes.
How exciting that must be.
It is.
Yep. Let's hope for everybody who has to deal with this terrible disease that your company will be a huge success. And thank you for being my guest.
Thank you for having me.